Okay, the final item of business this evening is a member's business debate on motion 12165 in the name of David Torrens on celebrating 125 years of learning with Fife College. The debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I invite members wishing to participate to press the request to speak buttons, and I call on David Torrens to open the debate around 7 minutes. Mr. Torrens.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It is an immense honour to open the member's business debate today, as we mark an extraordinary milestone in the history of Fife College, 125 years of delivering education and opportunities to people of Fife and across Scotland. As alumnus of Fife College, it is a privilege to lead this debate today. I'd like to thank my colleagues who have given their support to this motion. I'd also like to welcome our visitors to the Chamber today who are representing Fife College, including the Principal Jim Metcalf and the Vice Principal Sarah Jane Linton, who have travelled here to celebrate this important occasion with us. And of course, a special mention must be given to Fife College professional cookery and hospitality students, who are here this evening to take over the Parliament's restaurant and are already hard at work preparing for tonight's service. My staff and I, along with a number of my colleagues, are looking forward to sampling the delicious menu that they have planned. 125 years ago, a bold vision was realised in the heart of Fife, the establishment of an institution dedicated to providing accessible, high-quality education to all who sought it. Since its inception, Fife College has remained steadfast in its commitment to fostering academic excellence, innovation and inclusivity. Today, as we celebrate the milestone anniversary, we pay tribute to the pioneers and the visionaries who have shaped the college journey and made it a beacon of learning as it is today. It was in 1899 that Fife College, then known as Lauder Technical College, was established by a local politician and businessman, George Lauder. With a generous funding from his nephew and renowned industrialist, Andrew Carnegie, the college emerged as the first ever college in Fife, laying the foundation for a tradition of excellence in education that has endured for over a century. As many will know, the history of Fife is deeply interwoven in the coal mining industry, and the legacy of the mines left behind an economic, cultural and societal shift for everyone across Fife. Kirkcaldy Technical College and the new Lauder College at Hull Beef, formed from the old Lauder and Cairn Beef colleges, adapted quickly to this major industrial shift, offering former miners a plethora of educational opportunities, which was desperately needed in the coalfield communities, as the institution offered tailored courses, programmes and services. Following the further measure of Adam Smith College, Carnegie College and non-land-based elements of Elmwood Campus of Ruley College, as SRUC, in 2013, Fife College, as we know it today, was created. The college has long been a champion of diversity and inclusion, providing opportunities for individuals from all walks of life to pursue their educational aspirations, and shaping their lives by equipping students with the skills and knowledge and confidence needed to succeed in an increasingly complex and interconnected world. The students' past and present and future are the heartbeat of a college. It is their ambition, creativity and curiosity that drives Fife College to continue, innovate and inspire. Throughout this 125-year journey, one thing has remained constant, and that is the college's commitment to its core mission, to provide high-quality education and skills training that prepares students for the real world. Hundreds of thousands of learners have walked through its doors, many of whom have gone on to achieve remarkable things. Take William Curley, for example, a world-renowned and award-winning pâtissier and an expert in all things chocolate. Born in Methil and trained in Glenrothes College, he gained the skills that would lead him into training with the country's finest chefs. Some have even gone on to become well-kent faces on our TV screens, such as Shirley Henderson, Dure Scott and Edith Bowman, to name just a few. From engineers to artists, from healthcare professionals to entrepreneurs, Fife Council has been a launchpad for our careers, helping fuel industries that drive our local economy and national economies. However, this milestone is just about looking back. It's about recognising how Fife College is moving forward. In an ever-changing world, the importance of adaptability and lifelong learning has never been greater. The education landscape is shifting at a rapid pace, and in response to Fife College continues to evolve, embracing digital learning, green technologies and industry partnerships to ensure that students are equipped with not only the knowledge, but with skills and the values that will help them thrive in tomorrow's world. Through their partnership with Scottish Gas Network, to establish the UK's first ever hydrogen training facility, Fife College truly are at the forefront of helping to shape a cleaner and greener future for Scotland. By upskilling more than 200 gas engineers at their cutting-edge Leavenworth campus, they are training the vital future workforce the country so desperately needs to make the transition to clean energy. creating a new net zero workforce in Fife by upskilling existing gas safety registered engineers to work with hydrogen gas. These engineers will work with SNG H100 Fife project, the first trial in the world to deliver green hydrogen gas into homes for heating and cooking. We also have Scotland's first net zero tertiary education facility on its way, with addition of the newest Fife College facility in Dunfermline Learning Campus. The new facility is the first major development to adapt Scottish Government's net zero public sector building standards and will be net zero ready on completion. Modern, flexible and low carbon, the campus will deliver a first-class sustainable learning environment, giving students the best learning experience possible. Education is more than just a pathway to knowledge. It's a transformative force that empowers individuals to reach their full potential and create a positive change in their lives and communities. Fife College has served as a catalyst for transformation, equipping students with the skills and knowledge and confidence needed to succeed in an increasingly complex and interconnected world. Through its diverse range of programmes and initiatives, the college has opened its doors to new opportunities, expanded horizons and inspired generations of Fifers to dream big and pursue their aspirations. Reflecting my own time at Kirkcaldy campus, which is more years ago than I care to admit, I remind the opportunities it provided me to pursue my educational aspirations and achieve my goals in mechanical engineering. Fife College empowered me to unlock my full potential and chart my own path to success. One of the most enduring aspects of experience was a sense of community that permeated every aspect of campus life. During my time there, I forged friendships and professional connections that have enriched my life immeasurably. More recently, as an MSP, I've had the privilege of witnessing firsthand the positive impact that Fife College has on individuals, families and businesses throughout the region. The college commitments to accessibility and inclusion means that everyone with a desire to learn has a chance to do so, whether it's through apprenticeships, part-time courses, full-time studies or degree courses. Fife College offers pathways for everyone. As we reflect the past 125 years, we must also look to the future with optimism and determination. In an era defined by rapid technology advancements and global challenges, the role of education has never been more critical, and I know that Fife College will continue to evolve and innovate, embracing new opportunities and embracing challenges while staying true to its core values and missions. In conclusion, Presiding Officer, as a former student, I am deeply honoured to have this opportunity to share my reflections on the profound impact the college has had on my life and the lives of countless others. Looking ahead, I am confident that Fife College will continue to build on its legacy of excellence, contributing not only to the prosperity of Fife, but also of Scotland as a whole. As we move forward, let us remember the words of Nelson Mandela. Education is the most powerful weapon which we can use to change the world. Fife College has been wielding that power for 125 years, and I am excited to see a transformation impact it will continue to have for generations to come. Thank you and congratulations to Fife College on 125 years of extraordinary years.
Thank you. We now move to the open debate. I call first Alexander Stewart to be followed by Annabel Ewing. Around 4 minutes, Mr. Stewart.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm grateful for this opportunity to pay tribute to the history and the achievements of Fife College, and I thank David Torrance for bringing this debate to the Chamber this afternoon. This debate's Parliament's opportunity to recognise a legacy of learning which has been growing for over a century. The motion speaks about Lauder Technical College, founded in 1899. The modern-day Fife College also includes previous institutions such as the former Buckhaven Mining School, Cowdenbeath Technical College and Kirkcaldy Technical School. Fast forward to today and the college is the home of over 20,000 students. It has 5 campuses spread across the heart of Fife where they deliver 400 further and higher education courses. During summer recess, I visited the college's Dunfermline campus, where I had a constructive and very positive meeting with the principal, Jim Metcalf. Jim is focused on raising the college's profile and delivering community benefits and economic growth across the region. He is just over a year in post, and I have no doubt that the college will continue to flourish under his stewardship. As with other colleges across Scotland, Fife College is expanding its international outreach and building strong relationships with overseas partners. The college awards an annual bursary for college students to study in the US, And this year, the Dunfermline-based student Cameron Proven and Megan Simpson were given the opportunity to study in New York. These bursaries were awarded by William Garner, who is the great-great-grandson of the college founder, George Lauder. They form an important part of the college's Adam Smith Scholarship Programme. I therefore welcome the college's plans as part of its 125th anniversary celebrations to further develop this international outreach. This will include strengthening ties with institutions in the US, such as the Carnegie Mellon University in Pittsburgh. This university shares common heritage with both George Lauder and Andrew Carnegie. Presiding Officer, Scotland's colleges play such an important role in our further and higher education landscape. It is important that we take every opportunity to celebrate the work that they do at the highest benefits for individuals and their career paths. Unfortunately, however, the work of our colleges is becoming more and more difficult. Sian Struthers, the outgoing Chief Executive of College Scotland, has highlighted the uncertainty that colleges are facing. Cuts are inevitable, and they have been falling for the last many years. And we now know that 17% has been taken off over the last 3 years. Colleges stand ready to tackle Scotland's skills shortages, whether this is in Fife or in other parts of Scotland, Presiding Officer. It is currently, as it stands, facing an uphill battle with that mission. This debate is therefore welcome, and it gives us an opportunity not only to celebrate the college's achievements, but also to highlight some of the challenges they are facing. For 125 years, Fife College has provided opportunity for young people, and it continues to go from strength to strength. So in conclusion, Presiding Officer, I welcome the opportunity this evening to celebrate this college's success and congratulate the college staff, the college students and the alumni who are reaching out and doing a lot during this anniversary. And I wish them all the best for the future as they continue to inspire young minds, create new skills and open up opportunities for the future for people all across Mid-Scotland and Fife. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Mr Stewart. I now call Annabel Ewing to be followed by Claire Baker. Around 4 minutes, Ms Ewing.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I am very pleased indeed to have been called to speak in this debate this evening on Fife College's 125th anniversary. And I congratulate my colleague, David Torrens, MSP for Kirkcaldy, for having secured the debate. And I too welcome to the gallery the representatives from Fife College. And I must say that I'm very much looking forward to the fabulous meal that Fife College catering students are preparing as we speak, as they take over the members' restaurant for the evening. We have heard from David Torrens about the origins of the college, and it comes, of course, as no surprise to hear that Andrew Carnegie played a key role. And what foresight was shown in 1899 to establish a place of learning to provide opportunities for all, and to contribute to the economic prosperity of communities across Fife. As MSP for Cowdenbeath constituency, I have seen at first hand what a key role Fife College has played in ensuring that all young people have a chance in life, a chance to learn a trade, a chance to pursue their interests in a myriad of courses, and a chance to start their journey into the world of work. When I was Minister for Youth Employment some years ago now, I had the opportunity to work to ensure that the Developing the Young Workforce programme, devised under the leadership of Sir Ian Wood, was in fact put into practice. And I know how enthusiastically this was taken up by schools across Fife and by Fife College. Since that time, the core principles have, I would say, become actually embedded in Fife, perhaps not in certain other parts of Scotland, but certainly embedded in Fife, and have benefited thousands of young people. We have seen many foundation apprenticeships, we have seen modern apprenticeships, we have seen graduate apprenticeships right across Fife, with key support provided by the college and by local businesses. We have seen, too, close relationships between the schools and the college right across the kingdom, all intended to ensure that young people have options about their future and that no one, but no one, is written off. Indeed, Presiding Officer, there is not one sole single road to travel, and it is important that we do all that we can to ensure that young people know that and understand that. As has been referred to, there are a number of scholarship opportunities at Fife College, with the Adam Smith Scholarship Programme having been established in 1997. Since that time, I believe that over £1 million has been awarded in scholarships, with generous funding having been provided by a number of private sector companies and individuals. The scholarships, as well as providing rightful recognition of success, also, of course, have made a financial contribution to the students' lives and their education. And in some cases, as we have heard, that has involved study trips abroad, also internships, all designed to support and encourage students to achieve their full potential. I'm very pleased indeed to note the launch of the new 125th anniversary scholarship programme, and look forward to hearing about the detail of this programme, so that I can ensure that my constituents in Cowdenbeath constituency know exactly what may be on offer to them. Presiding Officer, I wish all staff at the college all the very best with the 125th anniversary celebrations, and I want to take this opportunity to thank them for all that they do to make a difference to the lives of young people across Fife and beyond. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Ewing. And I call Claire Baker to be followed by Mark Ruskell again, around 4 minutes. Ms Baker.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer, and thank you to David Torrens for bringing this debate to the Chamber, which gives us a welcome opportunity to highlight the College's 125th anniversary and to celebrate the College and its students and staff. The restaurant, I imagine, will be busy tonight, as professional cookery and hospitality students from Fife College are hosting a dining event in the Holiday Room. Collaborating with the in-house team in the kitchen and front of house, students from the college will be involved in all aspects of the event, and I am looking forward to dining there later this evening. Today, the college has been taking part in the Fife University and Higher Education Fair at Carnegie Conference Centre, and our colleges and their staff play a vital role in Scotland's education system. This year, Fife College guaranteed an offer of a place to all eligible school leavers in Fife who submitted an application in time, promising to help every school pupil who met the minimum entry requirements to find a course that suited their individual circumstances in order to help them achieve their potential. And the strength of colleges lies not just with school leavers, they provide a valuable route back to education and learning for many people. This 125th anniversary of Fife College is a significant milestone, and we are rightly celebrating the opportunities provided to and achieved by the thousands of students that have been educated there. Through strong links with both local areas and workplaces and relationships further afield, Fife College students are offered a broad educational experience that will help them prepare for the world of work, while ensuring they get the most of their time in education. The completion of the new campus in Dunfermline next year should provide another opportunity for partnership working with high schools, and I look forward to the official opening. Fife College runs one of the most substantial modern apprenticeship programmes in Scotland, and has partnered with over 189 employers, with apprentices from engineering, construction, automotive, plumbing, gas engineering and life sciences all beginning their journeys there. In August, the college welcomed a record intake of 350 first-year modern apprentices. This includes a record number of engineering modern apprentices, and the college has worked with 43 employers to provide opportunities for local engineers to earn while they learn, an important aspect of college learning. One of the college's key partners is Babcock, who deliver advanced manufacturing and shipbuilding in Rosyth. They will take on 400 apprentices over the next 4 years, and Fife College is this year providing 40 apprentices as part of its intake. Other partnerships include with the RES Group, which runs the Errolsfield Wind Farm just outside coal town of Weems, which supports 125 local apprentices in the renewable sector across the lifetime of the wind farm. The motion recognises the launch of the 125th Anniversary Scholarship Programme to empower and support students in their educational journey, building on relationships with institutions in the USA. As Annabel Ewan has recognised, the college already provides support through the Adam Smith Scholarship, with around 30 scholarships available each year. These are funded by a range of companies, individuals and organisations, including Shell, Diageo, Ian Rankin and the Russell Trust. The scholarships provide cash for resources like laptops, software and books, as well as offering mentoring and placement opportunities in the UK and abroad. As Alexander Stewart has highlighted, the George Lauder Bursary particularly continues the legacy of the college's founding benefactors, offering a valuable opportunity to study and live in the US for the summer, which is fully supported, including food, travel and accommodation. Another important aspect of student life is the social experience, and the Fife College Students Association works hard to support students in their classes and skills development, as well as in their social life through sports, societies and other events. This week there are various freshers events taking place, as well as a party to celebrate 10 years of the association. I have been delighted to attend their end-of-year showcase at the Glen Pavilion in Dunfermline, which was a chance to see some of the impressive work of the students on display, as well as talking to some of them about their experiences on the courses. From computer games to drama, there was a real range of work on show. And I was also pleased to attend the college's Creative Industries graduation in Kirkcaldy, where it was great to see the students celebrate and recognise all their hard work. So I am pleased that this afternoon and this evening we're able to celebrate this anniversary and recognise the hard work of all the Fife College staff and students, past and present. And I wish them the very best for continued success.
Thank you, Ms Baker. And I call Mark Ruskell to be followed by Alec Rowley. Around 4 minutes, Mr Ruskell.
Thank you very much. And can I join members in thanking David Torrance for moving this motion on 125 years of Fife College. And I think his motion rightly celebrates the origins of the college, its long history and the huge positive benefit it has had on generations of Fifers and their communities. And it was lovely to meet the students in the members' restaurant early on. There's a huge amount of enthusiasm there. And I think we're going to see some real stars of the hospitality sector emerge from that group of young people. So hugely optimistic. I'm looking forward to my dinner later on. But I want to share a few thoughts on the future of the college and the absolutely critical role that it's playing in this century in the fight against climate change. Because I think it's the colleges as much as, if not more than, the universities that will be needed at the front line of this fight. Because building the workforce of the future with practical skills for delivery of net zero infrastructure will be absolutely critical. Supply chains will need to be transformed in the next 5 years to decarbonise our homes, service wind farms, restore peatland and plant woodland. And even industrial big hitters like Moss Morran in Fife will need to transition to a cleaner, greener future. So I really welcome the fact that Fife College has already been part of that skills conversation at Moss Morran and has a range of courses that are really supporting that transition of our entire economy, because the growth of well-paid skilled jobs in the green economy needs to offer a bright future for young people at the start of their careers, as well as those looking to transition into new green jobs. So it's another reason why, as Greens, we want to see a restoration of the £26 million that was allocated in last year's budget for transformation in our college sector. And we cannot hold back when there are sectors of our economy that are unable to scale up to meet the challenge of climate change and the opportunity of climate change at the moment. So, you know, Claire Baker was talking about wind, and I remember visiting the students in Rosyth at the Fife College back in 2016 and meeting a number of students that were on the wind turbine technician course. It was really exciting to see the pride that they had in growing their skills and their expectations around apprenticeships and their expectations that they would be working on the next generation of wind farms. And it's great to see that, as Claire Baker was outlining, that some of those apprenticeships are now starting to come through. But I hope that those apprenticeships dramatically increase in the years ahead, because the doubling of onshore wind farm capacity between now and 2030 and the revolution that is gathering pace in offshore wind in particular points to a really bright future. And of course we know that there are investment opportunities in Fife that are coming, particularly around Burnt Island at the moment as well with offshore. So, you know, alongside that, also really recognise the work that's happening at Fife College's Leven campus to develop skills in green hydrogen. I think, to be fair, from my perspective, the jury remains out on whether hydrogen will ever be a cost-effective way to heat the majority of our homes. But it is an area of innovation, and decarbonising heating remains a huge opportunity in the next decade. So I do hope that the college can also realise the far bigger opportunities surrounding the installation and servicing of heat pumps, as well as district heating, which have the potential to power around a quarter of Scotland's homes. There's great jobs and great potential there, and I hope the college remains at the heart of that. Of course, climate change is about more than specialist professions. It affects us all. So I was pleased to see the focus that the whole college has brought to the issue. The Adam Smith Scholarships awarded 3 students for their writing and art, reflecting on what climate change means for them in their personal life and studies. It was a small but really important example of climate leadership. And Fife College's climate change strategy and action plan should also be commended. The cut in emissions by more than a half since 2014 is great progress, and plans to further strip out fossil fuel use from its operations are key, including Scotland's first net zero campus in Dunfermline, a huge milestone for the college and for Fife. So, Deputy Presiding Officer, to finish off, can I thank David Torrance again? I really enjoyed hearing about his own experience of going to college. I certainly cherish the time that I spent at college, at Stevenson College, many years ago. I thank the college staff who do such amazing work to inspire our young people and people returning to education. And can I just say, you know, let's look forward to the next 125 years. It's going to be momentous.
Thank you, Mr. Ruskell. I now call the final speaker in the open debate, Alec Rowley, around 4 minutes. Mr. Rowley.
Thanks, Presiding Officer. And I would also congratulate David Torrance on securing this debate today and celebrating this 125 years. And the motion I note says that the number of opportunities that have been available as a result of the college for thousands of students benefiting people and communities across Fife. And that's absolutely the case. I was reflecting the day back to when I was young, growing up in Fife, and you had 2 large industries in Fife. You had the pits, the coal mines, so the largest employer, the National Coal Board, and you had Rosyth Dockyard and Rosyth Naval Base, so the MOD. And if you grew up in Fife at that time, you got recruited, you got a job in one of these areas, you would end up at college. We called it the tech back in those days. But you would end up going to college and you would get an apprenticeship. And truth is, people my generation never look back. If they got an apprenticeship, they got real successful jobs and were successful in their lives. And that perhaps is one of the lessons that when we talk about and reflect back today, because there has been perhaps the last decade, the last couple of decades, a bit of an obsession that we had to get young people into universities, and that was somehow the goal. But actually, and I often say this when I go into schools and speak to pupils, I say to them that you could go to university or you could go to college. You get an opportunity in college, a career, a trade, and you will be successful. That's what life has taught me over these last number of years. So there has to be, as we look to the future, a discussion about the role of colleges, the importance of colleges, and indeed the direction. I was also reflecting today that I was at one point a member of Fife Regional Council and sat on the Education Committee in Fife Regional Council when the colleges came under the management of the local authorities. And there was clear direction in those days about where colleges were going and what it was they were to deliver for communities across Fife. And I think over the years, and we now have College Scotland, etc., I think some of the direction is missing. And I think it's to the government that we need to start setting out much more clearly what that direction needs to be. So yes, the relationship with employers, the partnerships with employers are very important. And I stress the word partnership. It's not about colleges dictating to employers what's available. It's about coming together and forming a partnership. But the reality is that right across Scotland right now, we have major skills gaps. We have skills gaps in other areas. So it's important that colleges continue to play an important role in supporting students around the social sciences. We also look at social care, and we see we have massive gaps in social care. We actually can't provide the services right now. And catering and hospitality, I meet companies up and down Scotland that tell me they're unable to recruit. Again, that requires, I believe, the government to look at an industrial strategy for the whole of Scotland, to look at the place within that for colleges, and to give much clearer direction. And I also want to draw attention, because Audit Scotland recently confirmed that the Scottish Government funding to colleges has been reduced in real terms by 17% by 21-22. Presiding Officer, I've met many college lecturers, many college staff over these last few years. Unfortunately, I've been meeting them on picket lines because I was there supporting them over the industrial action that we have seen. Thankfully, that now seems to have been put to bed. But my appeal to the Minister would be that the Scottish Government must give much clearer direction to colleges on what it is that we expect them to deliver and ensure that that is properly resourced. Well done to Fife College. They have had a major impact on the lives of so many up and down Fife over so many years, and I look forward to the restaurant tonight. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr Rowley. I now call on Graham Day to respond to the debate. Minister, around 7 minutes.
Many thanks, President Officer. Let me begin by adding my thanks to David Torrance for securing this debate and welcome being given the opportunity to celebrate the 125th anniversary of the first college in Fife. And as we reflect on an era which has straddled three different centuries, we can also look to what lies ahead, as Mr Torrance did in opening proceedings. As we've already heard, when considering how Fife College came to be what it is now, we have to go back to the founding of Lauder Technical School in Dunfermline, Buckhaven Mining School and Kirkcaldy Technical School back in 1929. A series of renaming and merging followed, with a number of colleges and technical schools delivering the skilled workforce needed by employers in Fife over those many decades. One thing these institutions in Fife have displayed is considerable adaptability as the times changed and the demands of employers changed with them. It's interesting to reflect on this journey as we look to the next chapter for Scotland's colleges within the reform of the post-16 education landscape. Decades ago, there tended to be more dominant local industries, as Alec Rowley noted, industry investment and training, and often a job for life. We've increasingly moved to a much more complex world where the dominant local industries and employers are more diverse, the skills demands within businesses are varied, the social, cultural and environmental backdrop has changed, and there's an increasing need for continued upskilling throughout our lifetime. This next chapter will require college delivery to again show how adaptable it can be. It will increasingly need to be agile and responsive to regional, social, economic, business and environmental needs. And I recognise that to do that, colleges will need to be trusted and enabled to deliver. So what might the next 125 years look like for Fife College and the wider college sector? Since college regionalisation around 10 years ago, the process by which Fife College came into being, Scotland's colleges have cemented their position as anchor institutions in the communities and regions that they serve. The recent reviews across our education and skills system have highlighted there is much good in the system, and it's important, Presiding Officer, that we recognise that. But there are improvements that can be made, and an appetite for reform exists widely. We, as the Government, have been clear on the broad actions we want to take forward, reforming the public body landscape, taking responsibility for skills planning and developing approaches that deliver autonomy to regions, enhancing and embedding the role of employers in shaping the system in partnership, as Alec Rowley called for, exploring the future of our National Career Service and reforming the way that funding is allocated and delivered. Now, I very much enjoyed Alec Rowley's speech, but I do disagree with him slightly on one thing. And that's his point about government directing colleges. I don't believe it's for government to prescriptively direct colleges, but what I think it is for government to do is to empower colleges, particularly their principals, to strike up the right local partnerships that Mr Rowley called for. Now, he also referenced resource. And I absolutely recognise, as I've done many times, there are financial challenges being faced by the colleges, a legacy of the austerity agenda of the previous Conservative government. And it's to be hoped the new Labour government in Westminster will be less inclined to undermine the ability of this government to support the FE sector, as I would want us to do. And all of the areas I noted a moment ago, colleges can and I believe will help to make a difference to learners and communities over the next number of years, just as Fife have done over the last 125. That's why we're committed to working with the sector and other key stakeholders and users of the system as we continue to develop our approach to reform. This is about making the system better, about ensuring we're getting the best outcomes for the significant investment we already make, and ultimately supporting students into sustainable, and rewarding employment. Exciting times lie ahead, particularly for Fife College, led by Principal Jim Metcalfe and Chair David Watt, who are with us tonight, along with a number of colleagues. In August, I had the pleasure of visiting the new Net Zero Dunfermline Learning Campus, along with the Cabinet Secretary, for the third time in my case, and it was good to tour the build and see how construction is progressing. It's an excellent example of the future of learning in Scotland, a shared campus for school children and college students with a focus on innovation and energy efficiency and the drive towards net zero. There is much to be celebrated at Fife College. The main articulation agreements with university partners and all the college's HND programmes having at least one articulation route with advanced standing into a degree course. And Fife College working closely with many employers of different sizes to design and deliver bespoke courses that provide employees with the skills and the qualifications necessary for their current roles and or successful career progression. From Lauder Technical School opening in 1899, further education in Fife has come a long way, but it retains the same underlying principles. In George Lauder's speech at the opening ceremony, he said, and I quote, "When I found myself at the age of 25 with a deficient education for the trade I had gotten engaged in, I resolved that every youth that came under my influence would get a good technical and literary training." That, in essence, remains the very heartbeat of our college sector today, to provide education and training for a wide group of learners with different backgrounds, experience and levels of prior attainment, giving them the opportunity to achieve their potential and obtain the qualifications required for a skilled workforce. In closing, Presiding Officer, I am pleased to note the range of scheduled commemorative events, from those involving the communities served by the college to those overseas where the influence of its founding fathers such as Carnegie and Lauder are well known. I think the launching of an alumni programme is also to be commended. I hope it will reveal some surprises. Who knows, maybe some alumni more famous than David Torrance. Presiding Officer, I want to close by wishing Fife College well in their celebrations and for the future as they build on the legacy of learning that Alexander Stewart referenced. Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate. Bon appétit, and I close this meeting.